So after the weekend, we'd visited the Maker Faire and we'd had our first trip of many to the markets. We went and visited our first factory on the Monday, which was Defond.
In fact, for some of the tour participants, it was the first factory that they ever visited.
Yeah, day four in Shenzhen, visiting our first factory. I didn't really know what to expect because it's hard to know what it's going to be like in a factory if you haven't been to one before.
I'd actually been quite interested in visiting Defond for a couple of years and hadn't had the opportunity to do so previously, but I had had some contact inside the factory and so was able to organise a visit to Defond for the tour.
After, a journey of maybe an hour or so on the bus through the crazy traffic again, we got to the factory and we were welcomed.
We were greeted by Arthur and Joe, who spoke excellent English.
We're always being pitched, and I think that's because there's quite a lot of competition between the manufacturers now.
All of the factories seem to have a fairly similar layout with a large foyer area, an area where they could display products they've made. We'd go into a meeting room somewhere and they would give us their presentation.
And when you visit a factory in China, they tend to follow a bit of a formula. What will happen is you arrive at the factory, you're greeted, typically taken into the boardroom, given a little bit of a presentation. They'll talk about the history of the company and then show you all of the machinery that they have.
It's really about selling the capabilities of the factory, giving their history, their experience, their other customers, what was the factory was capable of.
And kind of ran us through the whole process of what it would be to work with them.
And then did a little bit of a Q&A session with us and were able to provide insights into things like IP protection and due diligence, both from the side of the customer and from the side of the factory, so that you could actually work out whether somebody would be a good fit.
And then we got to see the factory, which was my first experience at a factory in China, and I was absolutely blown away by what I saw.
Whilst many of us understood the manufacturing process and seeing pictures and videos, it's nothing like actually going to a factory the first time and seeing this extraordinary equipment all laid out.
Defond is a sort of mid-size manufacturing company which is actually headquartered in Hong Kong.
Oh yeah, so it's fascinating because they started out with their business with switches.
And then they diversified, moved over to mainland China and started providing a wide range of services.
Now they just do everything across the board.
You can have anything made there that you want, basically everything from plastic parts to electronics to mechanical parts and so on.
Initially they were just selling their own products, which was the switches, and they still sell those, but they also do manufacturing for many other customers. So a lot of products that you buy under other brand names may have come out of a Defond factory.
It has factories located globally, including having recently acquired some facilities actually even in Canada to be able to do short run and prototype manufacturing, particularly targeting startups who are based in the US.
I was actually quite impressed by their manufactured lines.
The plant that we went to visit was the one that had closest to Shenzhen.
Defond was definitely a great place to start.
The first part is always the inbound component inspection, so they had offices for people who are checking all the parts and making sure they're up to specification.
Large facility, very clean.
The way they talk about quality control.
We put our dust jackets on and in we go.
It was really interesting seeing just the levels of automation versus still how much manual labour is used in those kind of factories.
Largely hand operated, so sort of in the middle tier of automation. They're not fully automated and they're not fully human labour.
And also seeing how organised and how systematic the whole process is.
They had a really nice setup, frankly. Lots of SMT lines.
Fully implement some of the lean methods.
It starts off with the SMT line, which usually is basically putting solder paste onto boards, then pick and place to place the components, then a wave soldering machine, and then usually an optical inspection of the parts to make sure that the soldering process was correct.
You know, this idea of China and Chinese manufacturing being this big amorphous thing was kind of, that preconception was kind of blown away in kind of just walking through the Defond factory, because it's a process they're very good at, but the thing starts, your components start at the beginning of the line, someone puts it together, someone solders it, it might go through a machine which might automate some of those processes, someone checks it at the end, it gets put on a box, and you made a thing.
Defond very much offers services centred around manufacturing, so design for manufacturing and mass production services.
And I thought, well, that's not nearly as scary as I thought it was. So yeah, I think that was really what I took away from the Defond tour.
Making a lot of products come out of there.
They had a number of SMT lines as well as various sort of tooling processes.
If you're going to do an SMT line with the solder paste, the stencil masks, the pick and places, the reflows, it's all going to be done clean.
Defond is what we'd call a box build manufacturer, in that they're able to not only do some components or sub-assemblies, but also able to deliver an entire product build.
Well, they're making a couple of 100,000 parts a month of multiple different lines.
They actually have facilities that are able to do plastic manufacturing, such as injection molding,
CNC work and wire cutting of molds,
metal forming, surface mount assembly, inspection, bore testing. So all of the components that are necessary necessary in delivering a hardware product.
There's quite a wide variety of services they can provide.
Defond was definitely a mid to higher tier company, but one of the highlights for me is some friends manufacturing at a lower tier company. They're now probably looking to go to Defond to higher quality manufacturing. So I think that was a highlight to have the tour introduce a potential producer of goods with a manufacturer.
For many factories, volume is really the important thing, but for companies like Defond, they really care about quality as well.
Some of the things that stood out for me for Defond as well was not only did they have the services to deliver the box build, they actually also had things like an on-site lab to be able to do certification testing, and in particular around their core products. So they're able to actually provide full services to their customers, and actually means the time to market is actually significantly reduced in that they're able to actually do in-house certification and testing.
One of the interesting stories we heard there is that they had a contact from a client come to them and say, can you make us 1,000 of these custom switches? And for a typical switch factory that's churning out 100,000 a day or whatever the number is, having someone say, I want you to make 1,000 custom switches, it's just not worth their while. But it turned out that these switches were to go in the dashboard of a special limited edition Porsche Cayenne. And so they did that job. The thing that they stressed to us is the importance of understanding the customer's needs. It's not just, can you make 10,000 of this for a customer? It might be the customer that wants 1,000 that is just as important.
There's a certain amount of investment that goes into starting that relationship. If it's only a one-off buy, if, you know, if party A, it's only a one-off buy, but party C, you're going to have return business, you're going to go with party C, which is a return business, because that kind of brings, you know, economic prosperity to everybody along the supply chain. As a startup or someone who wants something made, you actually have to pitch yourself to the factory. Like, it's not a transaction, it's a relationship.
So people think it's just a matter of showing up the front door and say, here's my design and here's some cash. It's not as simple, right? It's a mutual relationship where your manufacturing partner is also evaluating you.
Here in Australia, when we think about going to a service company, we think, you know, we'll pay you money, you give us the service. Whereas in China, it's more, yes, you pay the money for manufacturing and it's a service, but the relationship is just as important.
I think that first sort of engagement sort of set the tone for the rest of the tour. And as we walked through the facility, we could see excellent examples of manufacturing principles such as lean manufacturing and the way that the line was actually set up in a cell arrangement to ensure that material flow was efficient and the operators were maximizing in everything that was being done.
What I really liked about Defond was they had a group of engineers that were dedicated to setting up the lines. So they were process flow and optimization engineers, and they did a lot of work to validate the production line.
Not expecting the sophistication of the plant itself, the accessibility of the team, the engagement with orders or with startups and be able to grow with the business. So I think it was quite eye-opening for people.
A lot of thought had gone into making everybody feel welcome and making everyone feel comfortable with the process. And that comes down to this relationship building. Like, it's really thoughtful.
One of the things that really stood out for me was around intellectual property.
Besides their switches, they're really a manufacturing partner. They don't make any other products apart from the switches themselves. So it makes them a very viable option if I have a product to be less concerned that they might make an analog under their own brand.
And one of the points that I believe Joe or Arthur made in the presentation was around the fact that China only has about 400 IP lawyers. And so when you consider the number of lawyers and you consider the number of products being manufactured and those sort of things, that we can sort of understand where China is in terms of that IP protection journey and how they treat IP. So some of the interesting things out of the Defond visit that came out were in relation to, for instance, companies that had a headquarters in Hong Kong had perhaps a different respect for IP protection, particularly that came out of the British law. And so the way that they might treat IP or be informed about the importance of IP protection might be different to some of the companies that were registered in mainland China. As we walked through the factory, Defond also pointed out what strategies they used to protect IP. And so there was an abstraction between the jig and the fixture and the customer. So when you walked up, you could see this was fixture one, but you wouldn't necessarily know that fixture one was testing this part of the process for customer X, Y, and Z, unless you actually went and looked in a secure database and those sort of things. So they extracted some of the information from the operators as a way to protect IP.
Great insights from the tour.
So at the end of a visit, the business developers and the factory managers would usually come out to a restaurant with us, and we'd sit down and have a huge, great lunch banquet
So we had lunch with John Arthur after the DuPont visit at one of the largest Lazy Susans that we'd ever sat on.
With a Lazy Susan that was 3 metres in diameter.
It really was self-turning and we had to stop it. But it was just a nice experience to be able to extend in an informal setting.
But yeah, no, they're great. They're lovely people and they love to have a chat and talk about what your ideas are, what your plans and hopes and goals are.
One of the things around Chinese cultural practices and business practices is that informality and the sharing of a meal and the building of the relationship. So it was great for the team to be able to experience some of this.